people to be arrested at the SABC over financial fraud, and the Education Department manages to pay incentives to rural schools. With this update, I'm Khami Malazi. A number of people are due to be arrested following an investigation into the financial mess at the SABC. Head of the Special Investigative Unit, Willie Hofmeyer, says one person seems to be evading arrest, while a few others will also be sought by police soon. This comes after the unit investigated the SABC's financials following the Auditor General's report, which pointed to financial maladministration. Hofmeyer explains.
One arrest warrant has been issued and the Hawks are currently looking for the person who seems to be trying to evade arrest at this stage. And then there are two or three other cases already with the National Prosecuting Authority to make a final decision about issuing an arrest warrant.
Hofmeyer was at the SABC briefing the board on progress made on investigations following the auditor's report. He says 8 charges have been laid so far with the Hawks. These cases involve contracts worth well over 200 million rand. Hofmeyer says there have been probably many other SABC contracts.
In addition, we have prioritized the investigation about 34 contracts in total to the value of over 1.5 billion rand. And we're making good progress in those investigations as well. So we do expect that quite a lot more will be found in the next few months.
KwaZulu-Natal Education MEC Senzo Mchunu says his department has been able to pay incentives to rural schools. This is after disagreement with teacher unions. Mchunu was addressing KZN SATU conference in Durban today. He has, however, acknowledged that there is a serious backlog in infrastructural development in rural schools. He says the department will next day pay rural incentives to all teachers working in rural municipalities.
Rural incentives, we've had a big challenge over the past few years on this matter because we're not agreeing with Labour, right from national, on the criteria to identify a rural school so that you pay a rural teacher there. But nevertheless, we've already started implementing it amidst that disagreement. What we've now done is to succeed to align our views with Labour. We're now going to start implementing this as from 2012 using a different criteria, but also it will take more teachers than it is taking at the moment, starting in January 2012.
And finally, the fourth and last suspect in the murder of former Border Rugby Football Union marketing manager Pierre Bloom has been remanded in custody following a brief appearance in the East London Magistrate Court. He was not asked to plead and his case has been moved to the High Court for trial starting on the 28th of next month. Bloom was shot and killed while trying to apprehend robbers at a garage at Beacon Bay in East London in 2008. One of the suspects was later shot dead by police during a separate armed robbery, while two others are serving long jail terms. Bloom's widow D says her confidence in the police has been restored by their tireless efforts to bring the culprits to book. You can always catch the latest news on the hour on SABC radio stations and anytime here on NewsBreak Option 1.